Camelot Music was mainly a mall-based retailer store that sold stuff like cassettes, records, videotapes, and mainly music-related products. The founder was actually Paul David, who later sold his interest in the company to Investcorp. Investcorp is a company that owns multiple different businesses, including Gucci, Tiffany & Co., and Saks Fifth Avenue. He handed over his position to James Bonk, a 25-year veteran of the company. The company actually started in Massillon, Ohio back in 1956, but they didn't open their first retail store until 1965. The business started because Paul David, who is actually one of 13 siblings, was working as a sales rep for his brother, and he noticed that stores like department stores and drug stores were selling used records. So he started a business of a rack jobber. The definition of a rack jobber is a rack jobber operates by placing racks of products in stores, maintaining and stocking the displays, and paying the store for the space. Camelot still has some stores open, but they aren't as successful as they once were. Some stores that are similar to Camelot would be the Record Rack and Rust and Wax. Camelot Music didn't have too many competitors as their business model first started off small, but later on as they expanded, two of their biggest competitors would be Best Buy and Circuit City. Their competitors nearly put them out of business at the time that record sales were really dropping. They had lost a total of 90 stores out of their 360, but after this dilemma would bounce back with 500 stores. But back in 1996, Camelot Music recognized the situation they were in and filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy and eventually came to an agreement with their creditors. Soon after, they were able to launch a website called CD Genie and attempt to get back on their feet. The time that Camelot Music began had a lot to do with its success, because the 1960s was the time that record sales were really starting to take off. Paul David, the founder of Camelot Music, was very brave when he decided to switch his business style from wholesale business to opening his own music store in malls. And it was this decision that launched his business and really made it successful. The business was in its prime in the early 1990s. They had expanded to about 360 stores and bought out multiple record companies, including six from United Kingdom. Over the year, as any industry does, it changes, and Camelot Music was able to adapt to these changes in the marketplace and stay relevant. Ed DiPartolo Sr. was a businessman slash construction contractor and a good friend of Paul David. Paul David, who is the founder of Camelot Music, Carol David, who is Paul David's wife and someone Paul gives a lot of his credit to, Investcorp, the company that bought Camelot Music from Paul David, and James Bonk, the chief executive officer who took over Paul David's position. They filed for bankruptcy in August of 1996. Camelot Music had a huge amount of debt, and $300 million of it were due to Investcorp's leveraged buyout. And combined with the over 20% decrease in record sales, and it ensured the business's failure. With the company's crippling debt, bankruptcy was inevitable, but they were able to eliminate their debt, make a deal with their creditors, and eliminate Investcorp's stake in the company, making a comeback in the industry. Some believe that Paul David was responsible for the company's failure for accepting Investcorp's leverage buyout. This is Carol Cela. You can introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Carol Cela.
She's my aunt, and I'm going to be interviewing her
about, favorite aunt.
About the Camelot Music project. So the first question is, what's your memory about Camelot?
I remember Camelot. Well, Camelot used to be Specs, and that's where I used to.
And it turned into Camelot?
And it turned into Camelot, yeah.
How long ago was it that you interacted with Camelot Music?
A good 25 years ago.
Okay. Do you remember any negatives slash positives that you experienced with it?
Negatives, It was a little pricey. And then eventually the department stores like Target, for example, ended up, they started selling the music. So it was a better deal. So I would go there less and less, of course.
Any positives?
There were always one near me in a mall because I love to go mall shopping like a lot of people. And I was lucky enough to always live near a mall. So I did go to Specs and Camelot a lot.
So if there was a store near you right now, would you go?
I would absolutely go because, I just enjoyed the joy of going into a store and getting your music. It was a nice, experience.
The atmosphere and everything?
Atmosphere, yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you think, stores like Camelot could become popular again?
I think they can because people are more and more are looking to buy albums to collect and more people are purchasing record players now.
That's true.
And there's nothing better than the sound of a record playing on a record player. It's just a beautiful thing.
Well, thank you so much for your interview.
You're very welcome, my niece.
Camelot Music thrived in the free enterprise system, buying out other stores / competitors along their way to expansion. They were able to almost eliminate their debt and bounce back with even more stores than before. And although Camelot has had a lot of success, I have never personally heard or seen of them before this project. Camelot did a good job at keeping up with the times and adapting to changes, but like any other business in the music industry, they took a hit when record sales dropped.